Well, hello there. We're going to take a little time this morning to talk about a painting I worked on a little while ago based on my dog Snoopy, called A Blue Tie Event. Now that's Snoopy, my Boston Terrier. He's about just short of 8 years old right now, and I think you can tell already he was an inspiration for this particular painting, especially him wearing a bow tie, which I find to be particularly adorable. Now, full disclosure here, there's not really going to be a lot to talk about in this particular piece. I really just wanted more of an opportunity to talk about my dog than anything else. So without further ado, sit back, enjoy the music a little bit, and I'll tell you a little bit about Snoopy. Snoopy is his name. Mostly because I had this overwhelming desire when I had a dog to call him Snoop Dogg. So more often than not, I will call him either Snoop, Snoop Dogg, Snoop Doggy Dogg, or any of a number of different combinations, and he pretty much is smart enough to answer to all of it, so I like that quite a bit about him. But as I mentioned before, he's a Boston Terrier, and a little interesting thing about Boston Terriers, if you didn't know, times may have changed on this, but there was a time very, very recently, up until about the last 5 or 6 years ago, where the Boston Terrier was the only uniquely American breed of dog that existed. And the odd little story about that is that they were bred, obviously in Boston, around about the turn of the century in the early 1900s to be fighting dogs. Now, I know that's kind of cruel, but that is something of a fact of, you know, American history, is that there was a time and place in American history where dogs were bred to fight and fight other dogs, sometimes even bears and things like that, and bedding. Was placed on this, and it was meant to be something of a pastime. I'm not going to get into the morality of it. I think we all know where my feelings in that lie, but the interesting thing here is that, again, they were bred to be fighting dogs. They were part bulldog and part terrier, and this breeding hybrid was meant to make a more aggressive animal that would be a little bit more easy to stand up against larger animals like bears and stuff like that when they went into fighting rings and stuff like that. Breeding is an interesting thing, though. Apparently, as the story goes, they intended to get a fighting dog, but what they got was this really nice, friendly, cuddly puppy instead. And not having any use for that in the fighting world, these terriers, these Boston Terriers, as they became to be called, were really just not used for fighting at that point. They were really just kind of almost tossed out, so to speak. Now, again, as the story goes, the facts might be a little bit sketchy on this, but as the story goes, when they try to get rid of these dogs, kitchen staff around the neighborhood, people that you know, had access to, you know, cheap scraps of food and things like that, would take these dogs in, treat them as pets, and because they were so lovable and so adorable, and that was just kind of their personality as a result of the hybridization, became a nationally beloved breed of dog, and they thrived and became very popular up until today. Now, if we speak to modern day and speak to the things I can attest to, just from personal experience, Boston Terriers are lovable dogs. He is a cuddler. He had a lot of puppy in him at first, but as he's gotten a little bit older, he's grown to be something of a lap dog, and he is definitely my best companion. And I tell you, he looks great in a bow tie. I won't lie about that either. So the reason I think the bow tie works on him so well is because Snoopy is a breed of dog that is known very much by its markings, the black and white pattern that tends to evoke ideas of a tuxedo type pattern, and Snoopy here definitely has a good tuxedo going on. Above and beyond that, though, they're also very much characterized by their large satellite dish type ears, their squat snout, something that causes breathing issues quite a bit in these types of breeds of dogs, and of course their big wide eyes also. Drawing him was a lot of fun, but I'm not going to sit here and talk to you about that there was any specific technique I used or anything like that. It was really just a matter of taking a look at the photograph that I had, using it as inspiration, but not a direct resource or direct reference, and really just kind of sketching what kind of came to mind. And I think I mentioned this before, I'll say it again. I made this painting a little while ago, several months ago, as a matter of fact. This is one of my first early experiments with Procreate. So I really didn't understand everything in terms of blending layers or how to add in colors or shadow. Color theory was something I was just really kind of starting to experiment with at this point. So you'll notice here that I'm dealing largely with a black and white image before I even think about adding in color. And again, this is a good experiment for that because Snoopy is in fact largely black and white. There were splashes of color, certainly, to bring in with the bow tie and then the background a little bit later on. But these were, again, just me starting to stab and dabble in a little bit of color theory a little bit. Most of this was just black and white because it was more of an attempt to see what Procreate was capable of and what all the hype was about. And I'm proud to say that my artwork, at least in terms of my opinion, has come along leaps and bounds since this painting was done, mostly because the Procreate medium, the Procreate program, software, whatever you want to call it. It's a very forgiving software. It allows you to kind of go back and correct mistakes to the point that they're invisible. Although I won't say that's unique to Procreate. That's really anything I think that is a digital medium. And although I have very little experience with Photoshop, I know that you can do the same or something similar with Photoshop as well. Now, having said that, I want to just drop off at this point and let you enjoy the rest of the music and the rest of the painting here. But before I go, I will let you know here that the reason I'm going through some of my backlog is because I'm working on something big coming up in the near future that's going to require a lot of my time and attention. So I'm going to be publishing a little bit of my backlog for the next few days or so, maybe even going into the next week or so. I hope you enjoy it. And in the meantime, if you could, and if you haven't done so already, please take some time to subscribe, share. Let other people know about this channel. Let them know that this exists and let them know to subscribe as well if this is something they have some interest in. Anything you can do to spread the word would be greatly appreciated, and I'll be posting something similar on my Instagram account as well. In the meantime, thanks for your attention. Have a great day. I'd stop back in here for just a second to address the tag that you see down there at the bottom. The @jjoseph21122 is a reference to my Instagram account. That's the identity I post under. So if you're looking for more of my artwork, you can find it there under my Instagram account. You can just search for @jjoseph21122. I'll also put a link in the description.